So without much ado, let us go on now to our final project on building our website with HTML and CSS. Let's go to our final project right away. Okay, so let me open my device. It's come over here. This is where we start the other time. I want to start from here. And how do we do that? So let's just, without wasting time, without much ado, click on, let's create a class. Class name should be footer, okay? It should be footer. Class name should be footer. For each footer, that should be the class name. Should be footer. Let's go ahead and create the div.footer. I'm gonna create a div. Oh no, let's create a footer. That footer should have a class. So you also, the class too should be footer, so it should be footer.footer, okay? Footer.footer, that is a class. Bring your mouse down, get a div of container. The div of container, the class of the div should be container, okay? Class of the div should be container. Bring it in, and bring your mouse down again, you create another div. And the class of that div should be footer-1. You can name it anything, okay? But I'm going to name my footer-1. Okay, the div dot footer dash one. Okay, and after that, still bring it in. Then we now do our h4. Okay, don't forget it's h4, it's not h3, but h4. You can start to make it h3 or whatever. Okay, that's for me. I want to do it h4, and here I'm gonna write here 7. Okay, write here 7, civen. Okay, and after that, I want to go down again. I'm gonna go down again and create UL. Create UL, okay, which is on ordered list. Okay, ordered list, and in between the UL, I want to create something special. Okay, let me type it all because. I want to make sure what I want to type now should be completely okay. Completely okay. No. Bring it down. Yeah, let's now try what I want to type. Okay. The I, which is italics. Let's install it. So I stop this. And then we put an anchor tag. And in between the anchor tag, you know, we're not leading us anywhere. It's not leading us anywhere, so as usual, I put our also I shouldn't lead us anywhere. And then, in between that and the A that we've written before, we want to write about us, okay? Yes, about us. And I want to copy this and paste it, okay? So you copy it and paste it as usual. So let's copy this and paste. You paste it like 4 times, okay? So after barrels, next one should be our services. Our services. Then that should be privacy policy. The other one should be privacy policy. You know, just anything you feel like you want to create a page for, or they have a page for it already, you can do that, okay? So it doesn't mean that you also be privacy police. No, it just can be other thing. It can be your profile, it can be, you know, anything at all that you think. Okay? So I'll put affiliate program. Guys, or our affiliate, no, just affiliate program. program. Okay. And after this, one of paste, you will copy this, one of paste it in several places. Okay. So let's copy and paste in several places. So just copy us and paste. Look, I don't have to do it again. And here, the next one, change it to FAQ. And under the H4, it should be get help. Okay. It should be get help now. Talk about FAQ, contact, track your order, and payment. It shouldn't stop there. We have to paste again for another one. Let's repaste it again for another one. Copy this again and paste. Copy it and paste. Bring your mouse down. We'll copy it again and paste it. And then you have to change this. Let's change all this FAQ and the rest of them. Let's change it. For some reason, let's talk about get help. This one should be get help, okay? This one should be get help. So the H4 should be get help. As our FAQ and the rest of them, they are all there. So go another one again. This one should be follow us. This one should be follow us. The H4 here should be follow us. Follow us. Like follow us on Twitter, you know. Follow us. Then we change this as well. So being UL, I want to change this to div, okay? So it should be div. I also keep a class of div.footer1 as well. Alright, let's put an ID. Just copy this. After copying it, you paste it here, and then let's change it to our courses, okay? So here should be our courses. And what courses are you offering? And on the course you're offering, just know it and then write it down, okay? For me, I'll use software development. Software developer or development, anyone. Software development. And I'll go to the next one. Start to use web developer. Website builder, web developer. Now I'm just writing this, okay? So you can write whatever we are, you know, you're offering, you put it down there, write so that people will understand, okay? Then let's say, I think I'm into digital marketing, so I'll put digital marketing. Digital marketing. Digital marketing. And then this one, lastly, what can we put? Let's all think of something like dropshipping. Okay, let's put dropshipping. Dropshipping, okay. So after this, as usual, you bring your mouse and want to create another one. Okay, let's move on now. If you check very well, you see that you want to copy this. Just we've been copying others, so just copy it from the div as usual. Copy straight down to the end of the div. See, that's basically just this last time. Looking for paste. And yeah, I want to make some adjustments, okay? We leave the first div class to be footer one. Our head for now should be followers, okay? Just like getting followers on Facebook or stuff like that, okay? So you put it followers, okay? Followers. Also the first one and put followers. Follow outs, okay. Then we want to change this UL to div, okay? And the div should have a class, okay? So let's change it to div. And the div we're changing to should have a class, and the class should be social link. The div class should be social link, okay? The class, and the class should be social link, okay? Social, for the link, I just put dash link. But you can start to write it full link, okay? There's nothing bad about it. And here, you close the div. Okay, so you close the div. Close the div. That is it. Okay? So, and we'll all come over here and make changes. So for us to do this change, let's just cancel all of this and just maybe change to refer to one. And once generator 1 will now copy that one and paste it everywhere. Okay, copy that and paste it everywhere. So here, but let's say cancel this, don't need this. I want to create something completely different. So cancel everything here. Cancel everything here. Let's start with anchor tag. Then under the anchor tag, you have your href. So the link here, when it's not nothing, you have to put a hash. And you come over here and then put the I that we are using before. Put the I that we are using before. And this I should have a class. It's create a class in the I. Have a class. Have a class. And for that class, make sure that you type it exactly what I want to type right now. FAB, start with FAB, fab. Okay, fab. Give a space. FA. Give a line. Type Facebook. Facebook. Okay, FA Facebook. Then you put another dash. Then F. Okay, so in between, you can try to space it if you want to. Put dash then F, and we're now going to copy this and paste it on multiple places. Okay, so copy this, want to paste it on different fronts. Paste. How many now? That's just like four places, okay? So the first one should be our Facebook. And you close it. And the second one should be... It's not going to be Facebook again. We have to want to be our Twitter. FA dash Twitter. So the Twitter. Then the third one. Just any social media. Don't just try what I'm writing. Something that you belong to. Okay. You belong to Twitter. Do you have Twitter account? Do you have a Facebook account? Which account do you have? So based on the account you have, use it for that. Okay. Next one should be Instagram. Okay. I have an Instagram account. So I use Instagram on this again. Instagram, and then lastly LinkedIn. I have a LinkedIn account, so I'm gonna put LinkedIn. FA, you put your LinkedIn. It should be dash IN, okay? So that's LinkedIn account. Okay. So this, and you now come over here, it's a place you want to go. Just come over to Google, want to type something, I bring it. So for this to work, let me make it go so you see it. For all this anchor tag to work, let me just give you a brief explanation before we go on to show you how I can get what made this to work. But for this to work, we need to go to a website that's called Font CDN, okay? Font Awesome CDN. On that website, you're going to copy something and put it on the link. I'll show you in a GIF how you can do that. So that way, all the icons for these things, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and LinkedIn, will appear immediately, okay, automatically. So how do we do that? Let me show you practically how you can do this. So you come over to Google and you type Font Awesome. Let me just close it and type it myself. Type Font Awesome CDN, okay? Font Awesome CDN. You see already? Font Awesome CDN. And immediately open. Don't go to this, I just write Font Awesome. Look for where they write cdnjs.com from libraries, okay? That's where you go for, and you click on it. So when you click on it and it's open like this, you come over here, click on copy. You must copy it, okay? You must copy it here, and once you copy it, you now come back to our work, okay? You come back here, you scroll back to your link, to your head with the heading. Remember the head where you have your link for style sheet. Mail after your style sheet is the last one ahead. Bring it down and then get another link, okay? Get another link and then you paste everything. You create another link and paste everything. Okay, remember it should be linked to a style sheet. The type should be text to CSS. And after that, you now paste that you've copied from Font Awesome CDN. Okay, and once you've paste this, let me paste it. Let's now do Ctrl S for save and see if everything will appear. Of course, it has appeared. Yeah. It has appeared. Look at it. Everything else has appeared. Even our this thing is there already. Look at it. Everything is there. But though we lack features. So let's go ahead and use our CSS to design all this and make it look more real and more beautiful. Okay. Let me minimize. Let's go back to CSS and design all of that. Let's design all of that in CSS. Dot CSS, and inside the CSS, we want to start with the first one, which is dot container. Okay, let me scroll to where I've stopped. I've been working with CSS for quite some time now, so here I start with dot container. Container. Remember, your spelling should be correct, should be accurate. Okay, so you do your mouse width. Start with mouse width. And we want the mass width should be 1270. That should be okay. So from there we move on. After the mass width, let's go to margin. The margin should be auto. Margin auto. Okay. Margin auto. After the margin auto, we move on to box sizing. Whatever. All sizing should be whatever, okay. All sizing, let's make it whatever, okay. And we still bring our mouse then. At this juncture, let's stop there. Go to another row, click. Let's go to our dot row. Go to our dot row, which is ROW. Dot row. Bring it down. Bring it down. Then it should display flesh, okay? Display should be flesh. Display flesh. Want to display flesh? Display flesh. Sorry, there's a mistake here. Sorry, no dish. Should be display first. And the display should be flesh. The flesh. Let's bring our mouse down. Flesh wrap should be wrap, okay? Flesh wrap. Flesh wrap should be wrap. Okay? Let's bring our mouse down. And go to the next one, which is UL.
And let's continue.
Remember, we are now moving to UL. Let's go to our UL, okay? Let's try and color the UL list. As usual, add UL, you bring it down. Okay, very well. Then after UL, you go your code builder. And the code builder, bring it down. And let's go to list style. Let's go to list style, okay? List style. On the list style to be none. Don't have any list style on this, okay? So the list style should be none. Bring it down. Bring it down, let's leave that, let's go to the next one, which will be the footer. Now let's start working on the footer. Footer, then open your code browser. Bring it down. And let's add the background color. Let's give me background color. Okay. Background color. Let's make it a hash 242626. Okay. So make it to be hash 2426 and 26. Okay, so let's go to the next one. Let me give me a padding. The padding should be 20 pieces, 0. Let me pattern of 20 pieces and 0. 20 pieces. F0. We're going to hit this F0. Let's move hand. Bring our work down. Go to footer. Let's start another class of footer dash one. Let's create that. Let's design that. Footer dash one. Sorry, my footer spelling is over. And always be mindful of your spelling. Everything should move. We'll have the same thing with the HTML. Otherwise, it won't fly, okay? So footer dash one. Bring your code visual. Bring it in. Bring it in. Let's go. So want to make sure that give me a background, a width of 25%, this should be 25%. Okay. And after width, let's move on. Let's give him a padding. The padding should be 15 pieces. Padding of 15 pieces, okay? Give me padding of 15 pieces. 15 pieces. Okay? Padding of 15 pieces. Padding is 25%. That should be okay. Let's still move ahead. Let's leave it that way and move ahead. Okay? That's him put out. This time around, I want to see that our H4. footer.footer.h4.footer dash one, as usual, question dash one, and give a space, step your h4. Now I want to make sure that we design or style our h4. Okay, so for the h4, let's give me a font. On size of what should we give him as a font size? Let's make it 18 pieces, or let's make it 20 pieces, okay? Font size of 20 pieces. That should be okay. Can be 20, can be 18, anything you like, okay? Remember these things. There's no rule I said that it must be a particular font size, but anyone that is okay by you, give. Then let's give him a color. Just cut. Or that's want to color the write up. Should be hash FFF, okay? FFF up to 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Formula is an abbreviation. For now, let's do it completely. So you know, like actually use abbreviation or you do it completely. Anyone you do is gonna work, okay? So let's do test decoration. No, let's do test transform first. Let's transform. If I won't see me that, we have to bring it down so you can be to see me. Then if you can see me, of course it's there. Okay. Let's transform. Yes. Okay. It just should be, let's capitalize it. I want to be capitalized. I want to capitalize it. Yes, I'm going to be capitalized. So from there, let's move on and give me a margin. Let's give a margin to the bottom. Which should be margin bottom. Like, give me a point at more capitalized, margin bottom of 10 pixels. So let's give me a font weight, okay? Let's give me a font weight. Not appearing now, I don't know why, but that is the good of you knowing what you are doing. When you know what you are doing, be able to do these things yourself without even have to look for VS Code to help you to complete it for you, okay? So for the font weight, let's give me 500 pixels, okay? Let's give me 300. 300 pixels. Don't forget to always end it. Go to the next one. Now the font weight. Let's go ahead and make position. That should be relative, okay? Position relative. Position relative, yes. These have appeared and that is great. So we continue. Continue. I want my work. I want to format my work very well. So let's move on to that same footer again, the same around, same dot footer, dot footer dash one. Then we give it space. Now we are still talking on 8.4. So it should be 8.4. After your 8.4, give it space, put your two semicolon, and then write before, okay? Four. Then open your code browser, bring it down, and start with a container, the content, okay? Let's start the content, bring it down a little, that's what should be content. And on the content, don't put anything on the content, okay? Don't put anything on the content. Simply, just put a kind of apostrophe, okay? You can create apostrophe, like something like a quote. Okay? Just put it there. Or simply, let's make it three. Let's put three there. Two, three. That's all. Then bring it down. Go to position. Position should be absolute, okay? Position. Absolute. Then you go to the next one. Let me the left zero. Left. Left should be zero. Left should be zero. And bring it down. Let me the button to be 10 pixels. The button, let's make it 10 pixels, okay? Button 10 pixels. Bring it down. Let's go to the background color. Grand dash color. Grand dash color. Let's give him hash. Him hash of our libraries. Let me try this code and see if it will work. Let's see if this code will work. Then move ahead and give me height of 2 pixels. Height should be 2 pixels. Bring it down. Let's do boss hasn't to be border boss. your action. Bring it down. And may the height, that's with the width, to be 50 pieces. We should be 50 pieces. Okay. So I think that'll be all for that. Let's move on again to that same footer. Ethernet dot footer. Footer dash one. This time around, I'm gonna go to the UL. Okay, UL and LI. Let's try to design that. Give a space a little, that you know you're working. UL, give a space. LI, LI. I'm gonna work on UL and LI, and put a semicolon, and you type not. Okay, type not. Now open your code razor, and in between the code razor, just type, no, not code razor, sorry. Don't put a open a bracket. Don't forget here, you open a bracket. Okay, I'm trying to give some rules first before we continue our work, okay? So it should be last child. Last hyphen child, okay? And then you close it, and then now open a code razor for us to complete construction. So for that, all you want to play is just margin. Okay, margin bottom should be 10 pieces, that's all. Just margin bottom. Margin bottom should just be 10 pieces, okay? Now I think that should be all for the rule that we gave to the child, last child, okay? So bring it down. Bring it down. Put your dot footer again. It's on the footer dash one, it's on that class, it's on ULLI, but I want to now style the A, because the anchor tag. UL, give a space, LI, give a space, and then move on to the anchor tag, which is A. Then open your code reader. Yeah, I want to do some kind of work. Let's do it. Let's start with font size, okay? Font size. So let's make that to be 16, 18 pieces. Make it 18 pieces. 18 pieces of font size. And from there, let's go to test transform to be capitalized, okay? Test transform. You see, it start coming up again. When it stop working, that should not stop your work. Okay, keep doing what you're doing. It'll come up again, okay? To launch. The one matter is for you to know the address. So without the help of VS Code, you can actually code these things all alone by yourself. If VS Code able to complete it faster, better. If it didn't work, must go on. You want to tell your client that you're unable to do it because your VS Code was not completing it. That's why the first for you to learn it by heart. That is the first instruction. Learn by heart. Don't cram, but just know the rules and follow it. Like, how many are you going to climb? You can't climb it, but you can actually follow the rules. Okay? So, from test transform, let's go to color. Let's give me color. And the color I should like to, should that's in the SC giving the FFF that I've been using for some time now, okay? Let's give me a color of FFF. Then we want to test the creation. Test the creation. That should be none. Okay. Let's go to font width. I'm making 305, okay. Let's go to color. Let's add another color. This should be harsh. Sorry, forget that it's not working well for us. Sorry. But I think this is by itself, so I have to be very, very careful. Oh no. Then your hash tab. Let's do B, 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 okay? And it's your code ratio. Bring back. The display should be blocked, okay? The display, you want it to be blocked. Display as block. Okay. Let's do transition, okay? So that we can move to transit. Transition. Okay, let's continue. Transition, let's make it to be 0.5 seconds. 0.5, that's not long. Let me 0.3 seconds, okay? It could be 0.3 second ease. 0.3 second ease, okay? 0.3 second ease. Was it? So let's open another one, that same dot footer. All. Give your space. Li. Give your space. Put your E. Your semicolon and put hover. Okay. On hover. Once you've done, open your code razor, bring it down, go up, and add a color. And the color should be that same something like white, okay? HFFF. Okay. Okay. Bring your mouse down and then make padding to be 10 pieces, okay? That'll be a padding of 10 pieces. The padding of 10 pieces. Okay. That'll be a padding of 10 pieces. That's what I want it to be. So you close it. That's the add a few things around this board. Now that we need to create all of this, you know what we did, right? Yeah, we need to do that will be at the center, and all these things that just like to change each other, that they are all together, it's comes, right? Want to be a space, and then for him to transit, right? Transiting, okay? That to try to be a transition, and also when you buy it, to be showing, okay? This is exactly what we want to achieve. Our work. Let's check our work. Like I told you, always remember to save your work and then scroll it. Let's save, check what we did. Yeah, this is it. See, sovereign, switch. That's what we're talking about. And this is exactly what we plan to create. So we've achieved the goal, achieved this goal. But this one is no more, it's not yet working. If you take it very well, take how this one is moving. This is moving. And see how big they are. But look at this. This one, maybe because it's here, and because we've not really done any style on there, that's why it's still static, right? So I want to bring it down, and at the same time, add some kind of space, and increase the size, and stuff like that, so I can be like this, and then be able to kind of show its own color. When you go by it, you need to display another kind of color, okay? So let's go ahead and work on our social right away. At least we are going somewhere, so we're going to work on our social, no time. Let's go back to our CSS, type the CSS, it's somewhere around, we're going to social, okay? So scroll down, We went to where we stopped. So exactly where we stopped. So bring it down to be dot footer. We are still on footer. Dot footer one. Give a space. Dot social. Remember your class, the class name we give for this. For this is social, okay? So it should be dot social. Dot social dash LNK. That's the way I want to type there as link, okay? LNK. If you want to complete that link, anything you want. The other thing, they are not necessarily that it must be this name, can be any name you like. But one more time, you must always remember your class name and the exact spelling. Or possibly copy it and paste it here, okay? So, remember your code result. Your code result. So let's work on our footer for search. Dot footer. Remember, footer dash one is the class we are still working on. Give a space. Dot social. Dot social. Dot social. And remember that we didn't complete the spelling of link. We do LNK. That's my spelling. I don't know what you use. Whatever you use, come over there. And then let's move on to the anchor tag of it. Okay. Don't want to waste my time here. So bring it in here. Let it display inline block. Display inline block. Okay. So it should be inline block. Display inline block. And then the height, let's give me height of say 45%. Okay. And give me height of 45 pixels. 45 pixels. Height of 45 pixels. So bring your mouse on and give me width, and the width I want to give, I want it to be a width of that same, let's say 43 pieces. Let's make it 42 pieces. Sometimes you can make the height or the width anyone anywhere you like, or you can just do one and computer will automatically do the other. We've learned all of this, but in case you've missed this, the class, kindly come over. Take us out in our WhatsApp group so I can able to learn all these things from scratch. We actually started from somewhere. So right now we are just wrapping it up. It's our final project on HTML and CSS class. And on that final project, we agreed I want to create a fresh website from the scratch using just HTML and CSS to wrap up the final project. That's exactly what we are doing right away, okay? So in case you don't know how to get to this stage, kindly go back or check if you are on my YouTube. If you're watching me direct from YouTube, just check my playlist. You see where I talk about return to HTML, return to CSS, put them stage by stage. You get over here, and this will be very simple for you once you are here, okay? So let's continue. Give me a width. Let me redo the background colors, okay? So let me make background color. And color, I want to use RGBA, and what I want to use, sorry, now open your blankets. I'll start with 255 first, 255, comma, give a space, 255, comma, give a space, 255, comma, give a space, and this should be 0.2. Okay, I don't want to be that transparent. 0.2. Will it be too transparent? No, let me make it 0.6. Yeah, 0.6 is better. 0.6. Okay. Then bring it down. Add the background. Did our background color. Okay. So what we want to do now is border radius. Let's do a border radius. Or should I go margin? Yes, so test align. Let's test align the center. Align. Yes. Test align. Test align. Let's make it center. Just align center. And bring it down. Let's go to line height. That give me a line height. That give me a line height. They give me line height. The line height should be 45 pieces. 45 pieces line height. Bring it down. Let's do our border radius. Give me border radius. Border radius. And the border radius. Let's make it 50 pieces, okay? 50 pieces. Bring it down. And let's add a color this time around. Let's color our write-up. So the color I want to give should be that same white, the complete white, okay? So it should be complete white, FFF. So FFF. Bring it down. Then let's put transition. Let's make transition. Making transition, and then let's apply to all. Apply to all. So let's make it 0.4, okay? 0.4 seconds. 0.4 seconds. 0.4 seconds. So transition, I want it to be like, it should be all, it should apply to all, okay, apply to all, and I want it to be like 0.5 seconds, I mean 0.4 seconds, 0.4 seconds, okay, 0.4 seconds, and it should ease. Okay, not easy now, just ease, okay? So, close it, bring it in, and I think that should be all for this. So let's now go and add hover effect to it, okay? And I know you know how to add hover effects. So, let's go and add hover effect. Should still be the same thing that we've been using. Dot footer dash one. Footer-1, give a space, dot social, LNK. I don't know what you use, but whatever I use, make sure I put exactly what you use, okay? Exactly what you use, okay? And then, our anchor tag, that's what I want to transit, our anchor tag. And really, after the anchor tag, remember your semicolon, then hover. So these are things you must always remember. Other things will come in and flow like that. And when you forget anything, don't forget your best friend. And that is Google. Google it, okay? Google it. Google is there for you. Search for it. And it's going to give you ways that you can actually get a solution. And when you apply them rightly, you're going to settle most of the problem, okay? So, for this, let's move on and give him a color. Let's give him a color. What color will I give this time around? What color do you think will be right? Does he go for this yellow? Yeah, let's go for it. Let's go for it, okay? After all, it's dark gray. So if you add that color, I don't think it's them too bad. But if I don't like it, I can change the color at any time. So let's go for it. So you bring it in. And in order thing to add to it, not the color, let's give a background color. We give me a background color, okay? Background dash color. And for that, let's give hash FFF. I've told you why your work should always be uniform. Maintain same color. There's no point using different colors, okay? In a world, everything should rhyme. If you want your work to rhyme, you must maintain the same colors, okay? Let's now save it and run it and see if everything is okay. It has to be okay because everything we did is correct. We want it to be like this. It should be moving the way this one said, moving as well. So let's save it and see how it is. May not go to the device. So you have it saved yours. If you save it, let's now again check. Look at it. Everything, you see what is happening? When you touch the hover, when you hover the F, usually Facebook will turn to this particular color. You cannot see it. Are you understand? You come over to your Twitter, it also be the same thing. See it, you turn to this particular color. And come over to your LinkedIn, the same process. So this is how you make your work to be uniform. Okay. I believe with this, we've really gone far learning. But this is not the end. I want to wrap it up today. Today I'm going to end our final project with the website completely from the scratch using HTML and CSS. So let's wrap it up with the copy. Let's do it like produced by, you know, after some work, you see at the tail end of the work, you see that you write produced or created or designed by. So that's what I want us to do right now. Let me show you how we can achieve this, okay? So let's go ahead and design the footer page, okay? I like this. It's making me very happy, you know, and I know you can do something more than this. So please be dedicated. But if you are determined, you can actually create it like this, because after all, I've taught you from the scratch. We started with introduction to HTML and then move on to CSS before we go to this final stage of building a complete website from the scratch using just HTML and CSS. So how far can you create it? If you can't, go back to my class and work over it again. If you're a new person here, kindly go to the link below and join our WhatsApp group. So I will teach you from scratch on how you can be able to create something like this. Okay, so let's move on now to the next one. What we are going for now is to finalize everything. So just come over email after the div. Let me make it bold so I can see what I'm doing. I don't see where I want to put this. Let's scroll down straight to the last. Yeah, here should be okay. In between the footer, the last entry, between the last div and footer, you want to create a h4, and on that h4 too, you want to have a class. Okay, let's give the class foot, since we already have footer. Class of foot. And then in between, we'll type our copyright. So start with copyright. Type your copyright. Then you give a space and you pull your shift key and press end. Okay, with your shift key, my hand is on number 7. I don't know where yours will be, but just so your shift key, you press the hand. And once you press hand, in between, no need of giving any space at all, you just type copy. Okay, copy. This is what we're talking about. Okay, just and copy. Okay, then you write the following seven, or put in your name, seven teams. Okay, seven dash, it should be a dash teams, dash teams. Okay, then you give a space again. When I first stop here, I give a space again. Then you write created by, then write your seven teams or seven coding academy. By seven coding academy, seven coding academy, and you end it up again and write all right reserve. Let's give him this. Then all right, you don't need all of this, but in case you just want to, we're just playing around it. Okay, so you can play around it. Type anything you want. Okay, type anything you want. All right reserved. All right draft. Okay, so you have your bookstore. Okay, and we can actually put this on a bold. Let's this better by 17. Let 17 be bold. And you know your bold, right? Yeah, that's your bold. Then you cut this off so it should be at the center of it. cut it. Just cut it. And mail after all right reserve. Bring it down here. Yes. So bring it down there. Four full stop, then before you close the closing tag for H4. So let's do Ctrl S and see if our work. You just have to. Let's come over here. And check our work with lifesaver. You see? Just have to appear, but remember we've not designed it yet. This is it. It's too dark for you, but don't worry. But now we'll be designing, everything will look gorgeous. Everything will look great. But let's move on to CSS and then work on this, okay? Remember we have a class. We name it the class of foot. So bring it in dot foot. Dot foot is our class. And open your code browser. Bring it down, bring it down. Take it up. So let's start with the font size, okay? I want the font size to be font size. Let me give him 16 pieces. 16 pieces. If you like, I give me a font family if you want to. Okay, if you don't want to, no problem. So bring it down. Let's go to text transform. I want to be capitalized. Text transform. I want that capitalized, okay? Bring it down. Bring it down. Then let's go to font width. Font width. I want my font width to be between around 350 pixels. Let me make it 320 pixels. 320 pixels. Bring it down. Bring it down. And I want to add a color. And the color I want to give, I want that color to be BBBBB. Let me give me BBBB. Okay. Now I can change the color if I don't like it. You can change any color you like. You can use your code. You can use your write it. You know, we do well on color. We've taught you everything about color. So make your choice and choose what you like. Okay. Then the display, I want the display to be block. Display should be block. Display should be block. And then we want it to have a transition. You have a transition. Transition should be, should I make it 0.5? Let me do 0.5-ish. 0.5 second. And ease. I also want that transition to be in all. Anyway, it's just one line, so there's no point doing that. But if you want to, you can actually do it if you actually want to do it, okay? So bring it down, bring it down. Then I think that should be all for this. So should we, let me go up here and put justify, okay? Justify content. Make it center. Make it center. Center. Justify content should be center. Before the transition, nothing, anything I can do. So let's go to the next one. Let's go and put the hover effect on it. Okay, let's put the hover effect on it. So still on dot foot. Still on dot foot. Then put your normal stuff. Then hover. Okay, hover. Mm-hmm. Then bring your code browser. Bring it in. So just add color and background color as usual. Okay, so I want you to have a color. Color I want to give it now. I want harsh. Sorry. Harsh. 242626. 24626. Okay. Not enough. Then bring it down. Let's make background color. The background color. The background color I want to give should be aqua. The background color of aqua. Should I use azure? Let's be uniform. Thinking of something that will be okay. I can change it anytime, but let it be like this. Let it be aqua. Okay. So you have to save your work. Let's run it. Click your index.html. Click on open lifesaver. And let's see how everything is. Just have to be okay. Wow. Lovely, lovely. See it? So I can actually change this color and make it this. Okay. in line with this. Okay, so let's go ahead and change this color. So everything will now, it's about pairing with this green. Or do I have something like green? I be, what's it called? I have some this color, this aqua. I be something on my, whichever I have something like aqua on my background. But at the same time, I don't like the way it's appears. So let me change it to this or to any others. How do we do that? You have to do it very simple. So let's see, come over to the background color. That man, instead of using aqua, let's use that same color. This is the color. So you can actually copy it. And copy it. It's another method. Just copy the color. Come over here to where there is aqua. And then paste it there. Okay. And that is rich. That is rich. That's apply. And you are going to S for save. So let's go back and see, run it again. Open with lifesaver. Let's make it big. Let's make it big. Scroll down. And here's it. You see it? Everything rhymes together. So far so good. I've taught you how you can actually create a website from the scratch using just HTML and CSS. Of course, like I said before now, these are barrels, these are services, our privacy policy. They are all the same method, okay? All you need to do just for you, you can even copy the same thing that is here, but change the wordings. You write about you, what your company is all about, what you can produce, and stuff like that. And for your contact, you can take this to your contacts and make sure that people can feel online and in line with you. And this your followers on this, you know, your social handle, take it to your contacts. Okay? So they can appear on your pay homepage and on your contacts. And under the terms and condition, you know how to write terms and condition. And by the way, let me also market myself here. I write terms and condition for people. I write privacy policy for people. I return policy for people with just a few charges. If you're in Nigeria, you have a website already. We want to add terms and conditions. Remember, without terms and conditions, Google and other search engine, even other affiliate website will not accept you. Come over, meet me, I will write it for you with a token, okay? And if you also want me to build a website for you, I'll create a powerful website for you. Any website you want me to create for you, be it e-commerce, normal website, any website you can think of, okay? I will create it for you for a token as well. And I work both with WordPress and with coding. This is what I use coding. And if you check my website, the one I did with WordPress, you'll be surprised. And that is why I have two training. One is for digital marketing and this is for coding. In my digital marketing training, I'm going to teach you how you can build a website completely from the scratch using WordPress. Okay, that is very easy. Just like drop and drag, drag and drop, drag and drop, and just edit some things. Okay. So I believe we come to the end of this. But like I said, I still have a project for you. If you want it, DM me and I'll send it to you for a token as well. That project is 6 hours tutorial that will just guide you through all this process and ensure you can create a bigger website. Okay? Maybe something like YouTube or that big website you can think of. I can actually create them using just HTML and CSS. You can use that to be practicing along with this, so I can be able to perfect your way in HTML and CSS. But we'll now move on to JavaScript and the rest of other programming languages. Having said this, I will say this way, we'll call it off for this class. See you in other classes, waiting to hear from you. Remember to submit what you did so I can check it and see if you have accomplished something like this. Congratulations once again for being there from day one to today. And please, if since the day one you've been with me tonight, not subscribed to my channel, then what are you waiting for? Just take a few seconds now, click on that subscription button, so at any time I release a video, you'll be the first to get notified. And share this to your friends, your loved ones, those who are interested in programming. Bring them in. Let's teach them for free, okay? Though the next day, like I said, I'm going to pay a token. I'm going to teach JavaScript for free. I promise to teach you HTML and CSS for free. Others are not going to be for free. But with little money, since you're already in my group, I'm going to teach you. So see you there. Bye.